Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over quizzes inside of Microsoft Forms. But our lesson today is to show you that if you want to create a quiz and be able to grade it, to not put in a loophole that allows your students to cheat. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So here I am back on office.com. I've gone down here to the apps and I've selected Forms, which I can see right here. So I'm brought to the Microsoft Forms homepage. And if I go over here and I click New Quiz, let's just call this Test Cheating, because that's what we're doing. I'm going to show you how a student can cheat and then cannot cheat with the quiz that you set up in here. So let's say my test is going to have three questions, and I'm just going to make them all multiple choice. So I can hit Add New right here, and I will select a choice question. So for my first question, I can say, what year did the Civil War start? So now let's add the responses to the question. The first one is 1860. The second one is 1861. The third one is 1864. And let's add the last one of 1865. So now, once I've put those in, I can go back and indicate which one of these responses is the correct answer by clicking on this check mark right here. And that one will turn green and the rest will turn into X's. So next I'm going to scroll down here and go to Add New and Choice and say which element is the first on the periodic table. And let's put oxygen, boron, helium, and then I'm going to hit add option for hydrogen. And then I'm going to click the check mark for hydrogen. And then finally, I'm going to add new and go to a choice and say, who wrote A Tale of Two Cities? So some of my options can be William Shakespeare, Nathaniel Hawthorne, Jane Austen, or Charles Dickens. So let's check Charles Dickens for that one. So there's our quiz. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. I'm going to go up here to the send button and I can copy the link for my quiz. So now let's say I'm a student taking one of the quizzes. I'm going to open a new tab and paste the link. And I'm just going to fly through this quiz and just guess whatever the first answer on every one of them and hit submit. When I do that, I can see a button right here that says view results. When I click on view results, I can now see which questions I got correct and which ones I did not get correct. And I can also see what the correct answers are. So for the first one up here, I can see that it's the second answer, and then the fourth answer, and then the fourth answer. So what I could do is I could open up this quiz on one computer, and then I could take the quiz and get the questions wrong and remember what the correct answers are. And then I can open up a new tab on my computer where it registers under my name, and I can go through the quiz and do second, fourth, fourth, submit that, and view my results, and you can see that I have a 100 registered under my name. So how do we stop that from happening? Let's close up these two extra tabs right here and go over here under settings with these three dots and go to settings. Right here, this toggle button says show results automatically. If I turn that off and I go back to my quiz on a new tab and I take the quiz again, let's say I answer all the first answers again, and I go to submit, you can now see that that button has been removed and there is no way to view the results. So the downside of this is that your students will not get the immediate feedback of the correct answers for the quiz that they have just taken. And that is a valuable part of the learning process. But the upside to it is that they won't be able to take the quiz on another computer and then come back to their school computer and know what the right answers are and then submit the right answers under their name. So that's up to you as a teacher, how you want to deal with knowing about this issue inside of Microsoft Forms. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.